Welcome to the LVSHL playoffs, where four teams will be playing in the time of their lives. Many memories will be made, ones with joy, adrenaline, victory, and defeat. Not only will these teams have a chance at championship glory, but they will also have the chance to play in a very unique venue, the PPL Center, home of the Lehigh Valley Phantoms. After a 12-game regular season and seven teams competing for a playoff spot, only four now remain. Let's now take a look at what they have brought to the table. It's nice to finally see Nazareth back in the postseason. It has been some time since they were last here, and they were 1 point shy of clinching a spot last season. But none of that matters now. They are here and have brought some interesting pieces to keep an eye on. One would be Eagles points leader Tyler Glenn. I've always liked him since Phantom's youth, and I'm happy to see him back in the playoffs. Another offensive piece is Spencer Simmons, who leads the team in goals with 8. And how can I not mention their best player, Ryan Murphy, the starting goaltender for the Eagles. His stats are impressive, but listen to this one. In his last 3 games, he has saved 122 of 124 shots on net. He has been great, but I think he's going to need some help from his offense. Nazareth has played with some competitiveness against their playoff opponent in Northampton when they only lost to them 1-0 in the end of the regular season not too long ago. Keep in mind, however, for the first round of these playoffs, it's one and done. Can these Eagles take flight? We'll find out soon enough. Northampton has been a dynamic juggernaut all season long. If you look at their final scores, you would think that they were being coached by John Kreese from Cobra Kai. It's because this team shows no mercy. This offense is such a joy to witness every single week. And right away, I've got to talk about Lorenzo Tita. This guy has speed of lightning and the roar of thunder. One of the best players in the league, as he averages 2.64 points per game. But he is far from being the only note in this group. There is much more. Right behind Tita and the team leaders for points are excellent forwards such as Gavin Mullikoff, Ryder Ault, and Bryce Shockey. Reliable defenders in Brock Wazaris and Nicholas Shockey are also well worth mentioning. Don't forget their concrete wall in Valen Smargiassi, who is one of the best goaltenders in the league. There's also that McRae Ross guy. He may not be a top forward on his team, but I like him, so here is his reference. Expectations are high for the orange and black, not called the Flyers. A top record of 11-1-0 on paper should expect results. The kids seem to have trouble scoring on Nazareth goaltender Ryan Murphy in their last meeting. Northampton would end up winning that game 1-0 over the Eagles, but I am curious to see how the offense will perform against Nazareth in the playoffs this March. I do believe the kids have the talent to win it all, but will they complete their quest of glory? We shall see. Bethlehem is a team that started off the year on a tear. A 4-0-1 record was impressive, but as the year went on, they seemed to have trouble against tougher teams like Northampton and Nazareth. Not to say Bethlehem didn't beat any good teams this season, because they certainly did on occasion. I'm just saying a 2-3-1 record against playoff teams is a little bit inconsistent. Luckily, from their perspective, their opponent Southern Lehigh is a team they have yet to lose to this season. On their roster is a formidable group of athletes. Leading the way is Tyler Bertelsen, who at this time has the second most points by any player in the LVSHL with 30 points total. Behind him are other dangerous tools in the offense, such as Nick Monez, Donovan Richards, Brady Roos, and Ryan Hathaway. Solid depth like Thomas Pyor-Pavel, Landon McRae, Dominic Natozzi, and others are always useful to have on a team. Bethlehem made the playoff semifinals last year, only to lose to Central Catholic. is being in the first round a second straight year the charm. This time, they'll have to defeat this next team to find out. I must admit, I was feeling a lot of skepticism about this team for the first half of the year. If you are a sport and watching this, you're probably yelling at the screen right now asking why. Allow me to explain. First, they tied to Bethlehem in the fog, in which there wasn't much really to judge considering the fact that nothing was even seen throughout the whole game. But the next week got me worried, however. Losing to Northampton 6-1 was painful. The Spartans would get their first victory after barely defeating a weakened Saints team, but they took the win anyway. They then won three of their last four in their last few games before the end of 2022, but it came with an asterisk. Suddenly, I had yet to win over a legit opponent. I was beginning to fear that losing seniors like Aiden Pale, Colton Balco, Clay Chemnitz, and Patrick Laughlin was really starting to hurt the team. But once we got into 2023, the Spartans began to play to their real potential. Impressive and gutsy victories over Nazareth and Northampton, with the Spartans finishing the season strong and mighty. With them is a strong guardian in the crease named Blake Bennard. With him in front of him is solid and remarkable defensemen in Jack Casey and James Penninger, putting up steady numbers on the stat sheet all year. One of the best rookies in the league in Eric Kloss, while wearing that magical Patrick Laughlin number 7. And then there is him. All hail Anthony Greco. He is a gecko god that is currently in his prime. Be careful though, his skills might blind you from his true greatness. He is one of 8 seniors on the Spartans as Southern Lehigh will pursue to defend their title. And while they have failed to defeat their playoff opponent in Bethlehem during the regular season, for someone that has been watching this team all year, I can say that they have vastly improved since their last meeting. Now, will their momentum translate into the playoffs? That is up to them to decide. You can judge the many strengths and weaknesses of all 4 teams, but considering the fact that the first round of these playoffs is a 1-game elimination, everyone has a shot at true glory. All games in the postseason will take place at the PPL Center, and on Thursday, March 2nd, the varsity playoffs will begin. Northampton with the top seed will take on Nazareth in the first game, while Bethlehem will play Southern Lehigh later on that same night. The winners of these 2 games will advance to a best-of-3 final. It's the same format as last year's playoffs. I intend to broadcast the entire varsity playoffs this year, live, only on Knicks Hockey Broadcast. And before the games begin, I just wanted to take a moment to say that broadcasting hockey in the Lehigh Valley has become something extremely special to me in this last year. If you are just simply a player, coach, parent, or whatever else watching this right now, I just have to say one thing. Thank you. It really means a lot. I've enjoyed these games just as much as you like watching my content. This season has been fun, to say the least, and I will help make these playoffs memorable. See you soon.